Hi friends, today I would like to talk about who introduced the word university first on this globe. Ancient India was called as the world's teacher, Jagat Guru or world's guru. The entire world looked at India for seeking knowledge. In India, we had world's first universities. Indian universities were replete with students, teachers, and scholars. They came to India all the way from far off countries in search of learning. Let's talk about Takshila first. The oldest university known to the world is Takshila. It flourished around 7th century BC. Today, the ruins of Takshila speak volumes about its past glory. The leftovers of this once glorious university are situated in today's Rawalpindi district of Pakistan. It was famed to lodge 10,000 students from all over the world. Every student used to spend 8 years in this university. Education was imparted in 68 faculties like Vedas, world languages, Sanskrit, fine arts and professional skills, logic, medicine, mathematics, astronomy, warfare, commerce, politics and governance. Like so many faculties were here. Kautilya, he is also known as Chanakya, and Panini, Jivaka, Vishnu Sharma and many others were the celebrated gurus of this university. There are evidences to prove that the Greek philosopher Pythagoras and others had been the learners of this university. There is another university, it's Nalanda. Nalanda was the crown jewel of universities. It had a long and checkered history of fame. It existed from 5th century AD to 12th century AD. It was patronized by Hindu kings and Buddhist kings. Actually, it was famed as a Buddhist center of learning. Yet, Hindu thought, culture and philosophy and wisdom prevailed there. Temple ruins and historical references of various visitors substantiate that fact. Towards the southeast of Patna, the capital city of Bihar state in India, in a village called Bada Gyan, in surrounding area of which are the world famous ruins of Nalanda University. More than 2000 gurus and 10,000 students were stationed in Nalanda. The famous Chinese traveler and scholar Huyan Sang stayed here and has given a detailed description of the situations prevailing at the time. Careful excavations of this place has revealed many stupas, monasteries, hostels, staircases, meditation halls, lecture halls, and many other structures which speak of the splendor and grandeur of this place. Kings Kumar Gupta, Harshavardhana, and Ashoka had patronized this center of learning immensely. Nagarjuna, a Mahayana philosopher, Dinnaga, founder of school of logic, and Dharmapala, the Brahmin scholar, taught here. Historians estimate that around 20 lakh manuscripts existed in the library of Nalanda. Kasi and Kanchi were also regarded as highly centers of learning. The very unfortunate event in the year 1194 AD, a Muslim invader, Bakitar Khilji, had invaded this place and had burnt its books of learning. India's glorious knowledge vanished into the flames of fire with this satanic event. Thousands of students, teachers, and monks ran away to save themselves. Once Swami Vivekananda blames it as an historic blunder for not resisting this barbaric act and letting this wealth of knowledge consigned to blazes of fire. So, my dear friends, remember that our genetic memory and energy was marvelous. We have to awake that energy again within us. Thank you very much. Yours, Santosh Kumar, Karimilli.